Now, the last time Haircut 100 took their hits on the road, Margaret Thatcher was Prime Minister, and a pint of beer would cost you 61p. 61p.
Now, after 40 years, the band are getting back together for their first major UK tour. We're going to talk to them in just a moment, but let's take a look back at some of their greatest hits. We're joined now by Nick and Graham from Haircut 100. Morning.
Good morning.
You haven't changed a bit.
Bless you.
But you really haven't.
Ah, thank you.
What's it like watching that back now?
Just like watching old mates. You know, it's just lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, aww. Yeah. It's like looking back looking back at a different person as well. In some respects. Mm.
Who was that person?
He was happy, go lucky. Same kind of person that he's.
You're like that now, Jonesy. Aww. Don't give me that. You're like that now.
We haven't changed at all.
And I mean, it speaks of an era. We were here talking to Pete Waterman earlier about, you know, the 80s and some of their stuff. It feels like such a different time, and yet such an interest and a resurgence in what the 80s was. And for so many people, it was a really difficult time, but it was an exciting time, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. And I think our country needs this, doesn't it, Jonesy?
It does,
yeah. It's a bit gloomy. It needs a good burst, some burst of joy, I think, at the moment.
And that's what you were.
Yes, I mean, it was like the Gifford Circus of celebration. You know, it was like a bit of a carnival atmosphere. I mean, you go to a haircut gig and it's just like those songs, every time it comes around, it's like, I'm going to take it, I'm going to pace this one, I'm going to pace it, get on stage, and then haircut energy happens, doesn't it? It's like...
What happens?
Overwhelming.
Come on, what happens?
It's this overwhelming.
Describe it to us.
It's this like burst of adrenaline, isn't it?
And you can't describe it until you're in a band, actually. Until you're actually in a band and you're doing that with people, or whether you're a performer in some kind of a dance group or something. There's something magical that happens between certain members.
That camaraderie as well.
And you just suddenly come alive, and it brings out the best in each other's character.
And the audience reacts, I imagine, then, as well.
Yeah, everyone's part of it. The whole place, the roof kind of, like, lifts off. It's like a balloon gets higher and higher.
And is that the joy? Is it just that it's a door into a time capsule, and it takes you back to that time of a different era, but also just of a happier time, maybe?
Yeah.
It does. Well, music does transport you anyway. All music transports you to your favourite times and your favourite places. But it's also kind of it also brings you forward as well, because our children also listen to music. People we were in the charts with, and our children are now listening to that music, and it does.
And is that something you've noticed, that actually kids growing up now, they don't listen to music in the same way? They listen to music from lots of different eras.
Yes.
Yeah. They just it's like a second hand, like a vintage clothing store. You know, you listen to it and it's new to you. So you kind of, like, put on these clothes and it's like, wow, this is amazing. It just so happens to be vintage. I think people are drawn to that. I mean, I was. I mean, I grew up and, you know, listened to the Beatles 10 years after they'd split up, and I got into them. I didn't mind that they'd split up. I was kind of like, wow, just discovered it. It's new to you.
And so the way we consume music has changed, hasn't it? And what else has changed about this industry?
Well, you know, I watched the Wham documentary the other evening, which is so good, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really, like, good-natured thing. As good-natured as they were. Really lovely, lovely chaps. And, I mean, I just noticed how they were kind of at the gig and then they just jumped into the car and there was kind of screaming and mayhem going on. And kind of we had our haircut 100 mania, haircut mania moment. And I thought that's what we wanted when we were sort of growing up in rehearsals, in sort of grotty rehearsals around London. And then it happened, but now it's like a meet and greet and it's all very nice and orderly.
Mm. What do you mean?
Well, you don't come out of that gig and have that same situation now. You just go straight into a nice lounge. And you meet everybody. I know everybody, I think, now.
Oh, the audience
because
are now
of social
friends.
Media. Yeah, you just know everybody. You know everybody, and you can just chat to them. And I like chat about what they're up to now, and you know, how's grandchildren?
Oh, don't say that.
Yeah, that's cool.
So what? 40 years on, so you're about to do it all again, mm-hmm. embark on tour. Are you ready for it?
We're always ready.
Have you got the hunger for it?
Of course we are.
Yeah.
Can't you tell? I mean, it's like
it's twinning and everything.
Genuine enthusiasm here. It's like we are ready, aren't we?
Yeah, like I said before, unless you're in a band, you don't know what it's like.
Of course.
To have so that. Do you want to join the band? Come on stage.
Yeah, Ben can play the flute. Did you see? Ben's been trending for the last 24 hours, attempting to play the flute.
Attempting.
I'm not sure.
That is the key word.
I'm not sure either of us would make
Andrew
the band.
Andrew Webber didn't start just like playing brilliantly. He just had to. You work at it. Work at it, Ben.
Start somewhere. Yeah. But you do not want me in your band, just to be clear.
What will it be like for you? Obviously, there's the fun and the adrenaline. What will it be like for you being back on the road again?
Well, it's just going to be totally exciting. We're going to see lots of people who came the first time round, and we're going to see them again, and we're just going to give them exactly what they're after, which is just the haircut exuberance.
Yeah, yeah, and you know, let's face it, it's just like whatever you'd think was going to happen, it's not. It's overwhelmed when it actually happens. It's like that's the spirit of Haircut 100. It's just that joy that kind of takes over.
Does anything ever go wrong? What happens when stuff goes wrong on stage?
You make it part of the show.
Yes. Right.
Yeah, you incorporate.
Is that more
the whole
fun?
Because that's haircut spirit as well, isn't it, Graham?
Yeah, I'm sure you've had it on the show.
Oh, but,
you don't want things to be perfect, do you?
No.
Boring life. Life isn't perfect. It's a bit messy. Embrace it. Go with it.
I'll mess up all your notes.
I don't need them.
What is the most exciting thing, though, about this tour? Is it just, you know, working together so closely again? Because a tour is, you know, up close and personal. You'll be, you know, out on the road again.
Yeah. Well, we're OK. We lived together in one room, didn't we, above a flower shop in London, where we lived and breathed being the band, didn't we? And it was just so... We know what it's like. I know what Graham's socks... pants, the whole caboodle, you know, we know each other's foibles and things, so it's cool.
And you still clearly get on brilliantly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which says a lot.
There's a love there, there's a strong bond, it's love.
Love
we
that.
We can't wait to spread that love.
Yeah, we need more love in the world. Yeah.
And it's really infectious, I have to say, this morning. Cheered us up. So thank you.
Cool, nice.
Really nice.
Thank you. Loads and loads of luck.
And obviously, the tickets are available.
Well, you want to read that?
Yeah. That's
it. Look at that.
Oh, setting off on our... Yeah, tour from Dublin in October.
There you go.
And all the tickets are available via our website.
There you go. You said
mytickets.com.
Is that Sting supporting us?
It's nearly sold.
It's not.
It's a technical term.
I think it's nearly sold out as well. So people better
lovely
be quick.
To see you. Best see you. Of luck.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Stay where you are.
You are. It's very bossy. You're watching BBC Breakfast. It is 8:59.